In this video, I am going to demonstrate about uterus in different stages of development according to age and their morphology in cut section. First, let me briefly explain you about the uterus. The uterus is an inverted pear-shaped muscular organ of the female reproductive system. In humans, the lower end of the uterus, the cervix, opens into the vagina and upper end fundus is connected to the fallopian tubes. Now let me explain you why the uterus is different in different stages of life. The uterus is a dynamic female reproductive organ that is responsible for several reproductive functions, including menses, implantation, gestation, labor, and delivery. It is responsive to the hormonal changes within the body, which allows adaptation to the different stages of a woman's reproductive life. The uterus adjusts to reflect changes in ovarian steroid production during the menstrual cycle and displays rapid growth and specialized contractile activity during pregnancy and childbirth. It can also remain in a relatively quiescent state during the pre-pubertal and post-menopausal years. In fetus, the uterus is contained in the abdominal cavity, projecting beyond the superior aperture of the pelvis. The cervix is considerably larger than the body. Neonatal uterus. In this view, uterus of a neonate can be seen. The neonatal uterus is prominent under the influence of maternal and placental hormones. The cervix is larger than the fundus, with fundus to cervix ratio 1:2. The uterine length is 3.5 cm and the maximum thickness is 1.4 cm. In sonography, the endometrial line is often echogenic. Some fluids can also be seen within the endometrial cavity. Uterus at 4 years, prepubertal uterus. As we have seen about neonatal uterus, let's discuss about the uterus at 4 years, which is known to be prepubertal uterus. The prepubertal uterus has a tubular configuration in which anteroposterior cervix is equal to the anteroposterior fundus, or sometimes a spade shape, which means anteroposterior cervix larger than anteroposterior fundus. The endometrium is normally not apparent, however, high frequency transducers can demonstrate the central lining. The length is 2.5 to 4 cm and the thickness does not exceed 10 mm. Prepubertal uteruses are generally small, but during the reproductive years, the uterus may be larger. Uterus at puberty. Now coming to the uterus at pubertal age. At puberty, the uterus is pyriform in shape and weighs from 14 to 17 grams. It has descended into the pelvis, the fundus being just below the level of the superior aperture of this cavity. The pubertal uterus has the adult pear configuration in which fundus larger than the cervix and fundus to cervix ratio is 1:1 and is 5 to 8 cm long, 3 cm wide and 1.5 cm thick. In sonography, the endometrial lining can be seen and it varies with the phases of the menstrual cycle. Adult nulliparous uterus. In this view, adult nulliparous uterus can be seen, in which no previous pregnancy has occurred, can be smaller than a multiparous uterus, in which multiple pregnancies have occurred. In adult uterus, the body is bigger than cervix and fundus to cervix ratio is 2:1. Adult parous uterus. In this view of adult porous uterus, the parts of uterus can be seen. The fundus is the uppermost rounded portion of the uterus. It is the broad curved upper area in which fallopian tubes connect to the uterus. The fallopian tubes, also known as the uterine tubes or salpinges, are tubes that stretch from the ovaries to the uterus. The cervix is the lower part of the uterus in the human female reproductive system. The cervix is usually 2 to 3 cm long and roughly cylindrical in shape, which changes during pregnancy. The narrow central cervical canal runs along its entire length, connecting the uterine cavity and the lumen of the vagina. The opening into the uterus is called internal os. The opening into the vagina is called the external os. The endometrium is the inner epithelial layer along with its mucous membrane of the uterus. It has a basal layer and a functional layer. The functional layer thickens and then is shed during menstruation. The myometrium is located between the endometrium, which is the inner layer of the uterine wall, and serosa or perimetrium, the outer uterine layer. The myometrium is the thickest tissue of the uterus, which is composed of smooth muscle fibers. The lower part of the cervix, also known as the vaginal portion of the cervix or ectocervix, bulges into the top of the vagina. Adult postmenopausal uterus. In this view, adult postmenopausal uterus can be seen. The postmenopausal uterus appears small and atrophic to reflect the lack of hormonal stimulation and absent menstrual activity. Fundus is smaller than cervix and cervix to fundus ratio is 2:1.